Good morning, students. Our third chapter is completed, and I hope you have completed your all work. Today we'll be starting chapter 4, that is basic geometrical ideas. Before starting the chapter, we should know what is geometry. What is geometry? You must have listened this word. So can you tell me what is geometry? See students, mathematics is divided into three parts. One is arithmetic, second is algebra, and third is geometry. Arithmetic is all about number system. Arithmetic is all about number system. Three parts, mathematics is divided into three parts. Arithmetic, algebra, and geometry. Arithmetic is all about number system. Numbers, these LCM, HCF we have done, all comes under arithmetic. All chapters, all sums based on numbers comes under arithmetic. Algebra is all about variable and constants. You must have listened somewhere till you have not done this part of mathematics. In 6th class you must get introduction to algebra, but before that you have not done algebra. Algebra is about variable and constants. Variable and constant. You must have listened x plus y is equal to 2. This type of questions comes under algebra. Variable and constant. We'll not discuss much about this because you don't know what is algebra. We'll discuss it later. Third comes geometry. Geometry is all about shapes. Shapes, angles, triangles, construction. These all comes under geometry. So geometry is a branch of mathematics. Right, today we'll be discussing some concepts of geometry. What are the shapes in geometry? What is there in geometry? So it will be basics of geometry. Very first thing comes is, tell me what is it? It is point. What is point? It is known as smallest shape of geometry. It determines the location. Right? And it is being considered smallest shape of geometry. It has no length, no breadth. And it is the smallest shape. And whenever we give name to point, we always use a capital letter, capital alphabet. You can say point A, point B, C, any alphabet you can use to name the point. Right? So this was point. Next is line. What is line? A simple straight figure is called line. It has no initial point, no ending point. It can be extended in both the direction. Right? These arrows shows that it can be extended in both the directions. So again, it has not fixed length. Like, we cannot measure the length because it has no ends. Right? Length cannot be measured. length cannot be measured not having initial point and ending point, not having any starting point and initial point or starting point is the same thing, any starting point and ending point, right? This is line. Next comes ray. What is ray? Ray has a starting point. An initial point is always there, or ending point also can be there. This is ray. Right? Ray has one end point. It can be either initial or ending. Torch. Torch is an example of ray. It starts from the torch and goes to the other direction infinitely. Right? That is ray. Again, ray cannot be measured because it has one point, but other side there is no point, so it also cannot be measured and it has one end point. Ray has one end point. It can be starting or it can be ending. Ray has one end point and ray also cannot be measured. Ray cannot be measured. Cannot be measured. Next comes line segment. Line segment. Line segment. Line segment is a part of line, but it has two fixed points. Starting and ending both, let's say AB. This can be measured because AB has a fixed length, right? So we'll say line segment has two endpoints. Segment has two endpoints and line segment can be measured. It can be measured because it has a fixed length. You must have listened some time that draw a line segment of 3 cm. So we can draw a line segment only because we have a fixed length, right? Now we'll discuss types of line. Line, I told you, what is line? Line has no end point. It cannot be measured. Now we'll see what type of lines do we have. You are to write all these definitions in the starting of this chapter. Right? You will write all the definition, points, line, line segment, ray. Now we'll discussing the mode. That all you have to write in your notebook. Next we are discussing line. Line, I have told you what is line. Types of line I am telling you. One is intersecting lines. Intersecting lines. When two lines cut each other at one point. When two lines cut each other at one point. These are two lines cutting each other at point O. Right? Let's say this line is L1 and this is L2. So L1 and L2 are cutting each other at O. Cut or intersect is the same thing. So these are called intersecting lines. Right? These are intersecting lines. एंड वी हैव अ पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन, पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन, अ पॉइंट वेयर टू लाइन्स इंटरसेक्ट. एट विच पॉइंट बोथ द लाइन्स आर इंटरसेक्टिंग? ओ. सो ओ इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन. राइट, टू लाइन्स इंटरसेक्ट एट एनी पॉइंट आर कॉल्ड इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन्स. Sometimes two lines intersect at 90 degree. These were two lines intersect at any point. This was intersecting lines. Now I am saying if two lines intersect at 90 degree. So we call them perpendicular lines. We call them perpendicular lines. So tell me the basic difference between intersecting lines and perpendicular lines. Intersecting lines intersect at any point, and the point where they intersect is called point of intersection. And perpendicular lines are where two lines intersect at 90 degree. Right, here in the at the intersection point, the angle should be 90 degree. Then we can say that these two lines are perpendicular lines. Right? Fine. Next comes parallel lines. Parallel lines, you must have seen railway tracks. Right? Railway tracks. Railway tracks are parallel to each other. So this and this, let's say L1 and L2, these are parallel lines. They never meet each other. Parallel lines never meet each other. Distance between them is same at any point. Means this distance is same, this distance is same, this is same. Everywhere the distance between two lines is same always. Right? So never meet each other and distance between them is same. This distance between them is always same. Right, perpendicular lines intersect at 90 degree. Intersect at 90 degree. So this much for today. We have discussed point, line, ray, line segment, and intersecting lines, perpendicular lines, and parallel lines. So your today's work is to learn all the definitions, write in your notebook, and discuss about these lines. Find out some examples of these lines in your surroundings. Fine. So this much for today. Next, we'll discuss some other things about geometry in next video. Thank you.